Shall we dance?
Mother, please leave. I'm having so much fun.
And how long do you think that will last, wretched girl?
Oh, I get it. You're the wicked...
Sid, no name calling, or I'll have you sweeping out the fireplace faster than you can say scullery maid.
Mother, please don't ruin this for me. I'm right in the middle of a wonderful...
Fairy tale? Enjoy it, darling. You have until midnight.
Oh, no. Wait a minute. Oh, this is different. We're in the middle of the happily ever after part. I already have both the shoes.
Did you forget how this one ends?
I know. When the clock strikes 12, I turn back into my old self, dressed in tatters.
That's the children's version. This one is much spicier.
See, that's what I'm trying to tell you. This is different. We are rewriting this fairy tale.
Brace yourself, darling.
What's happening?
Sorry, Sid. I'm not a real prince. I'm the pumpkin driver.
How do you like them apples?
My feelings for Kyle have not changed.
That's my girl.
Don't you have a pumpkin to warm up?
I'm sorry, Mother, but I'm sticking with him no matter what happens.
Oh, really? And what if this isn't Kyle's last transformation?
Then I'll handle it. Bye-bye.
Suit yourself. But you better wear this. You're in for a bumpy ride.
Sleep. I kept thinking there was something really important that I, like, forgot to do.
Yeah, you need to help me pick out a casually funky yet stunning outfit for my date tonight.
No, I need to steal $1 million. While you're swimming in your post-coital bliss, I'm trapped in financial hell. My rent's being jacked up this month, and I'm barely getting by as it is.
I can lend you the money, Joanie.
It'll be the same next month. I don't do enough business to crack my humongous nut, and I don't even have an employee I pay anymore.
But what about relocating the Barkery?
That's just what I need to do. Ask my brilliant doctor's sister to add real estate agent on the list of her achievements.
It's not a big deal. Got a new doctor at the clinic today. Nope, I can actually take a lunch.
Morning.
Oh, thanks. But after moving costs, I'd be down to like $1.50 to get me into a new lease, cover my monthly expenses, and then, of course, buy diapers for Hannah.
Should have said something to me. I am an investor.
Oh, I'll put it in the stockholders' minutes.
Johnny, if you need a loan...
Dad, I can't take any more money from you.
What you need's a hook. Some mega event that'll suck in the customers.
I'll throw a benefit. I'll call it Barkery Aid.
Wait a minute. What about those pet talks you wanted Dad to do?
Oh, now that's a good idea. Go Sid.
No, I don't think so. My best audience is the furry variety.
Yeah, how much of a crowd do you think Dad's really gonna bring in?
Any crowd is a good start. Dad, please say you'll do it.
You're only talking about a few people, right?
Yeah, I mean, whoever comes. Not that many people, I'm sure.
Yeah, I guess if it was a small group...
Perfect. Tomorrow morning.
You want me to drop by? I could give you some pointers as an experienced manager.
Manager or moocher?
Morning.
Morning. Hey.
Joe?
Thanks.
Hey, Tinker. I'm sorry I didn't bring you a treat.
He wouldn't eat breakfast this morning. I don't know what his story is, but he wouldn't leave me alone.
I don't blame him.
Yeah?
Hey. Hmm? You feel kind of warm. You feeling okay?
Not so great, but I got the cure right here.
Bruce Springsteen at the Civic Center?
Tonight.
Never seen him in person.
To the boss.
Oh, there. Bill, please let me check your arm.
No, I just, I slept on it wrong. It's fine.
Well, at least promise me you'll see Dr. Jordan.
Yeah, sure. Look, I want to get to the center early tonight, all right? So, dinner in our seats, hot dogs, pretzels, the works, all right?
Yeah, sounds great.
It's good.
Dr. Hanson?
Yes.
Dr. Wesley, I don't usually arrive with my own patients, but I have a one-year-old here with dehydration.
Where's the mother?
White Honda. She's parked out front. She's doubled over with cramps. She can't move.
Patrice, can you go check on her?
Sure.
Dr. Wesley, follow me.
Sure.
Sorry to put you to work right away. Come on in. There you go. It's okay, sweetheart. All right.
No tears.
My skin turner's poor.
Yeah. Mucous membranes are dry.
You're gonna do fine. See if you can find a vein.
You think the anticubital?
Not on this side.
Okay, here we go.
Here's a butterfly.
Okay.
It's okay, honey. It's okay. Almost done. How you doing there?
There we go.
Hi. One more second. And guess what?
We're in.
You did so well.
Look at that.
Yeah. Nice working with you, Dr. Wesley.
Feelings mutual, Dr. Hanson.
Oh, my hell, it's my landlord. Hi, Mr. Varl.
Miss Hanson. As usual, your choice of dress is invigorating.
Thank you. Can I offer you a latte or perhaps a dog biscuit?
Permit me to show you the patio. It is particularly stimulating.
I can't believe it. I'm only 8 days late, and he's already showing the place.
And your lease agreement says what?
He can evict me after 10 days.
Looks like he's getting his ducks in a row.
Whose side are you on anyway?
An enjoyable day to you, Miss Hanson.
Don't you smile at me. I know exactly what you are up to.
I am merely looking over the premises with a business acquaintance.
Oh, yeah, you expect me to believe that. You don't even have the decency to wait for the body to get cold, do you?
Fine. I wait. Do you have the check?
No, I don't have the check.
2 more days. Then, the inevitable climaxing.
It's conclusion! All right, so that's it. I am dead meat.
Not necessarily. We just need to get a major buzz going.
Well, maybe a few people will come to Dad's pet talk thing.
Now, Joanie, that's just the band-aid. See, what you need are the jaws of life.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mrs. Harris. Franco can't have his abscess drained until the afternoon. Dr. Hanson won't be in tomorrow morning. He's giving a talk at the Barkery. At 11 on the dot. Okay, bye.
Little Heather, did I hear you correctly? Is Jim giving a speech tomorrow?
Well, it's more of a question and answer session about your pet. Not your pet specifically. Although, I think Kobe is an exceptionally handsome dog. What did you ask me?
The pet talk. It sounds fascinating.
Good morning, Cynthia. Kobe, old pal.
Oh, Jim, you are so modest. You never told me you were a public speaker.
Oh, I'm not. Oh, you mean the Barkery? Well, I'm certainly not looking forward to that. I'm not much for crowds.
Oh, a professional man like yourself, I'm sure you've been in the spotlight before.
Actually, I've managed to avoid it my whole life.
Well, then I definitely want to be there for your first time.
Oh, no, that's really not necessary. Cynthia, I don't think I'll be any good.
Well, it depends on who you're with, Jim. Whatever I can offer you by way of support is yours. All you have to do is ask.
I'll start to keep that in mind. Thanks. Kobe, let's take a look at that ear. Oh.
I also did my residency in L.A. Yeah. I know Stewart County. You must know Ted LaFong. He was the attending there for years in family practice.
Oh, of course. It's a great guy.
Yeah, he moved back east last year.
Well, I'd say we should all get together, but I don't exactly have that kind of life right now.
Me either. You know, I was reviewing your resume, and I'm curious, why is it that you're willing to take on locum tenens?
Well, my daughter Patty just started preschool, and I want to see how she adjusts before I take something permanent. Mm. This place must keep you really busy.
Well, it wasn't so bad until a few months ago when my partner decided to go back home and run her local hospital.
And you haven't been able to find full-time help?
A free clinic isn't everybody's first choice.
Hopefully I can help you fill the gap. So, do you need a day or so to check my references?
Everything looks pretty good.
You can call Dr. Halpern over at the Family Practice Clinic in Warwick. That was my first real job, and he knows me like a book.
Well, I will do that right away, but I don't foresee a problem. Welcome to St. Clair's.
Thank you.
Hey, Dr. Hansen.
Kyle, I hear you and Sid are going to see the boss.
Yeah, but I have a little problem. I thought you might give me some professional advice.
Sure, what's up?
That's Tinker. He's been acting really weird the last 24 hours.
How so?
Well, seems really freaked out about something.
Well, animals do have a kind of sixth sense about things.
You mean when, like, something bad's about to happen?
Hey, guys.
Hey.
What's up?
I think Tinker is feeling a little left out. Is he a Springsteen fan by any chance?
Actually, he loves them, especially the early stuff.
There you go. He's probably upset about not going to the concert.
Well, I can't say that I blame him.
Tell you what. Tink, come here. Hey, what do you say you and I build up a little fire and put on Born to Run and then have our own little Springsteen concert, huh? You think? Okay, come on.
Slower? Well, last time I saw Springsteen here, somebody was in my seats. I had to get the usher. It was a major hassle.
Well, you know, if you want to go sit in the seats, I don't mind waiting in line.
No, it's all right. I'm just hungry, and it's really hot in here.
It's not that hot.
It isn't?
You have a fever.
No, it's just the sweater. I shouldn't have worn it.
Sure you don't want to go sit down?
All right, yeah, maybe I will. It's just, there's no sense taking chances, right? And these tickets are really hard to come by. I would hate to...
Kyle? Kyle, you okay? Wait, put this under his head. Eli, just take a breath. Relax.
Okay.
Give me some cold water. It's okay. Just relax for a second.
When you need me, call my name. 'Cause without you, my life just wouldn't be the same. If you want me, them sunny skies are rain. When you need me, just call my name. If you miss me, I'll be there when you need me. Call my name. 'Cause without you, my life just isn't the same. 'Cause when this world kicked me around, baby, you picked me up off the ground.
you doing here?
What does it look like?
Stealing.
You try eating what passes for food in this dump. I'm lucky I'm still alive.
You should be in bed.
You gonna tell on me?
I just might.
I'll give you a fruit pie and two ho-hos if you keep quiet.
What happened to your leg?
Cancer. You feel sorry for me?
No, I think you're doing just fine.
You don't work here, do you?
It's a big hospital.
I've been here 9 times. I would have remembered you. So what's it gonna be? Come on, lady, I haven't got all night. Everyone's got a price.
Get back to your room. Dr. Jordan.
I heard Kyle was admitted with sepsis.
He's on Ceph and Benko. Dr. Melman's adding info. He thinks it could be fungal.
I've seen the results of his bone scan. There are a couple of hot spots in the distal humerus. I'm gonna get an MRI.
I thought the incidence of wound infection with limb salvage is unusual.
Extremely. I've only seen one occurrence in the past 7 years.
What happened?
We had to amputate the limb. I want to save Kyle's arm as much as you do. Let's hope he responds to the antibiotics.
Sid, how's Kyle?
Not good. He's septic. I should have known, Dad.
Unfortunately, the only one who saw it coming couldn't talk.
You think that's why Tinker was acting so strange yesterday?
Anything I can do?
No, you're already doing it, Dad.
I'll keep Tinker downstairs with me until Kyle's out of the woods.
Hey, Dad. Thanks. Patrice?
It's Dr. Wesley's idea. She has them filling out their own paperwork. And she set up a triage room for vitals and chief complaints.
All this before 8 o'clock.
She called me at home, asked if we could open up early.
Well, who's next?
Jenny Kovacs is in too, but Dr. Wesley's in with her now.
I mean, she didn't demand to see me?
Oh, yeah, she did. But after 2 minutes with Nancy, she was completely tamed. The woman has serious bedside manner.
Okay, I'm officially impressed. Did you get a chance to set up my call with her reference, Dr. Halpern?
He's on vacation for the rest of the week, but I left word for him to call us when he gets back.
Okay, why don't you get me another reference? I'll call when I get back from the hospital.
All right. What did you put in the flyers?
The usual. Time, location, possible topics of discussion, like mating rituals of exotic animals.
I'm disgusted, and yet deeply indebted.
Mm-hmm. I'd better come out of the bathroom pretty soon. You leave a crowd waiting too long, they turn ugly.
Stop it, you're making me nervous. And when I'm nervous, I have to pee.
So?
So Dad's in the bathroom.
Excuse me.
Dad, we need you, excuse me.
Dad, are you okay?
Just a little agita. It must be nerves.
Jim, honey, is there anything I can do to help you?
How about some water, Dad?
No, I'm all right. Actually, I can't breathe.
What should we do?
I don't know.
I'd better give him mouth to mouth.
Oh, no.
Make sure you don't feed him too much in the morning. He'll throw up.
Kyle, Tinker will be fine.
I know. Sorry, it's just... he's been acting strange lately, and... So how serious is this, Sid? This infection?
Your blood cultures came back positive, and the infection has localized at the salvage site. I'm worried that your arm could be at risk.
But let's just wait and see what the MRI shows, okay? I gotta go. I'll be back as soon as I can get away from the clinic, okay?
Well, take your time. I'm not going anywhere.
Thanks, Oscar. Come back in half an hour.
It'll be just another few minutes, Mr. Moran.
Hey, I was here first.
That's enough, Ben.
Actually, I was here first.
Come on, I'm only 11.
Well, I don't care if you're 111. I was still here. You know what? If you want, be my guest.
Never mind. I'm not in a hurry or anything. You a big Sea Dogs fan?
Oh, yeah. It's my lucky cat. I work for the team.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. They suck. I hate baseball.
How can you hate baseball?
I don't know. I just do. I can't play. I have a metal rod in my leg.
Well, we have something in common. I have one on my arm.
They have to keep making mine longer every few months because I'm growing. But yours should be no problem.
Well, if you say so.
Give it some time. The worst part is being in here. My advice? Eat from the vending machines whenever you can. You okay? Kathy! Kathy, this guy's in trouble!
Let's get some O2 in here.
His pulse isn't ready.
Paige Melman or Jordan?
Monica.
Ben, go wait out in the hallway. Now.
Thanks.
Okay.
Thanks.
See you later.
You can't stall them forever, Johnny.
Of course not. Just until I sell out the display case. Great. That will be $5.97.
Okay.
And I threw in an extra puppy pop.
Mrs. Blake? How's Dad doing?
He's still in the bathroom.
Everyone, can I have your attention?
I'm sorry for the delay. But our guest veterinarian has been detained by an emergency. Bad flu emergency.
So we came here for nothing?
No, no, we're still gonna have the pet talk, I promise. Day after tomorrow.
Okay?
Okay? Don't forget. Thank you so much for coming. I'll see you in 2 days.
Bye.
Bye. Oh, my hell. This pet talk idea is a gold mine.
Yeah, except for one small problem. Dad's got the worst case of nerves I've ever seen.
Oh, well, we can help him with that. Or at least you can, anyway. You can talk him into anything.
Dump it on me. Yeah, thanks a lot.
It's your gift, Rob.
Okay. I'll tell you what. I'll work on him if you give me another 10% of the Barkery.
What?
Your gift, Joanie.
His films. And? There's still edema around the bone, and it appears there is not enough arterial supply to heal this infection.
No. He'll never agree to it.
He has no choice. He's got overwhelming sepsis.
Then try another antibiotic.
We've already got him on triple antibiotics and an antifungal agent.
Then give him some time to fight it off.
It's not about saving his arm anymore, Sid. Kyle's fighting for his life. You know as well as I, amputation is our only chance of saving him.
Dad, how are you feeling?
I'm still embarrassed. I'm so sorry about what happened yesterday.
Dad, it's no big deal. Don't worry about it. Hey, have you heard from Sid?
She called from the hospital around midnight, but she was very vague.
Hey.
Hi, Sid.
Hi.
Is everything all right?
Kyle had a rare and extremely serious infection. They couldn't save his arm.
I'm so sorry.
He's already been through so much.
Have you seen him?
He's still heavily sedated.
Favorite sandwich from O'Neill's.
What's the occasion?
No occasion.
Isn't it funny? That's what Joanie said when she brought the fresh baked cookies.
Okay. Well, I wanted to talk to you about coming back to the Barkery tomorrow.
Robbie, not a chance. I've had enough public humiliation to last a lifetime. Thank you.
Jim? Oh, Jim. You poor man. I thought about you all last night. I brought you some gazpacho.
Why does everybody keep bringing me food? I had a panic attack, not malnutrition. Sorry, Cynthia, this is very sweet of you. Thank you.
You know, Jim, you have nothing to be ashamed of. Mm. Speaking in front of people can be absolutely terrifying.
Mm-hmm. Mrs. Blake.
I read an article once that said the only thing people fear more is actually dying in a fiery plane crash.
What happened to you? They're from my private stash. I figured you might be having a little trouble with the vending machines for a while. You don't owe me anything for them. They're like a present. Anyway, I'll be seeing you around, I guess.
Thank you so much, Dr. Wesley.
Anytime, Frank. And remember, don't twist your wrist picking up the 7-10 split.
Hey.
Hi.
Seem to have everything under control.
Well, I did a brief stint at Cook County in Chicago. After that, this is a piece of cake.
I don't recall Cook County being on your resume.
Well, I was there so briefly, I didn't think it was honest to include it.
Right. You know, I tried to reach your reference, Dr. Halpern, but he was on vacation.
Second week in October. The man takes the same vacation every year, standing in a trout stream in Montana. I'll get you another name.
Great. You know, I ran into Ted LaFong at the hospital. He doesn't seem to remember you.
I was still Nancy Cavanaugh then. Since my divorce, I've gone back to using my maiden name.
I see.
Oh, I should have mentioned it, but I get tunnel vision when I start a job. Other than work, nothing gets through.
How serious is a 3-day notice?
To pay or quit? My experience, extremely.
Was that somebody at the door?
Yeah, it was my landlord. I'm getting evicted.
Joanie, at least let me help you pay the rent this month. That'll give you some time to work out a solution.
Actually, Dad, I already have a solution, but you probably don't want to hear it. Mm. Okay, let me first just say that I am really, truly sorry. I did a really awful thing. I promised all the customers that you would come back for pet talk.
Why would you do that? That was a disaster.
Dad, they were buying out the store. It was like an answer to my prayers. All I need is just one more shot with these people. Please just bail me out this once. Oh, my God, I've turned into Robbie.
Thanks a lot.
Joanie, I can't go through that again.
Of course, I understand.
It's just too much to ask. No matter how many pets Dad could save.
What was that?
Oh, well, the dogs you see at the clinic belong to responsible pet owners. Mm-hmm. But what about all the other people who just don't know any better? You know, they don't bring their loved ones in for the shots or for the checkups. So the pet talk would be kind of like an outreach program.
Oh, Robbie, you are very clever.
What? Just something to think about.
Hi. How are you feeling? My father and Robbie and Joanie, they're all thinking about you. Would you like me to call somebody? Maybe your dad?
Nobody.
I spoke to Dr. Jordan, and your white cell count is improving. You're beating the infection. You can start occupational therapy right away.
Screw therapy. Why'd you let them do this to me?
You were gonna die. They had no choice.
You think this is better? Huh? I can't even look at myself.
It's totally normal to be angry.
Normal, is it? Wow. Thank you, Dr. Hansen. Thank you.
You just need to give yourself some time.
Yeah, that'll make a difference.
You're alive.
Good for me. Now get out. I said get out!
Sorry.
It's okay.
How do you get any sleep at all with him crowding you like that?
No. Poor guy has no idea what's going on.
Yeah, but he knows it's not good. You going back over there today?
Yeah, after I check in at the clinic.
How's the new doc working on?
She's great. You know, I wish I could hire her full time.
Minor miracle, if you ask me.
What do you mean?
Short notice, usually. End up settling for anybody that bothers to show up. You're desperate, you give them the benefit of the doubt. It's only later, after the dust settles, that you realize what you got on your hands. Come on, Tink, let's go for a walk. You get some rest.
Oh, God.
But don't look at me like that. I always do this.
Mr. Varro called. He's coming by to intercourse with me about the lease. God, I wish he'd learn English.
I think he already has.
Uh-huh.
Joanie, I've been thinking about it.
And?
I'll do it.
Yes, Dad. No. Thank you so much.
But, I've due to the end of the day after I close the clinic, 6 o'clock, and have an ambulance standing by.
Absolutely.
Rob, would it kill you to use a glass?
No problem.
Come back in a week and we'll take the sutures out, okay?
Mm-hmm. All right. Hi there.
Hey. Very nice suturing, Dr. Wesley. And as a plastic surgeon, I can be hard to please. How did she get the lacerations?
My little brother. Okay, give this prescription to your mom, and next time tell Ricky to use words.
I'd like to see you alone if I could. You meet me in the office?
Sure.
Sweetheart, why don't you just wait here for a second, okay? Patrice.
Yeah?
Just make sure this little girl doesn't leave. I'll be right back.
great manual. It was a lifesaver to me when I made my transition into family practice.
I don't think I've read this one.
That's a shame. If you had, you'd know that you never suture a human bite.
I beg your pardon?
There's simply too much bacteria. See, I have to remove those sutures and explain to a mother why I hired someone to work at my clinic who wasn't really a doctor.
I'm sorry.
Who are you?
Nancy Wesley, registered nurse. And I've worked in a variety of practices over the years, and I thought I picked up everything I needed.
Except an MD.
You gonna report me?
I have no choice. But I can offer an alternative.
What's that?
Community service. I'm willing to talk to the authorities about you volunteering here as a nurse.
You mean that?
Providing you get counseling, and you go back to school and get the training you need to advance to the next level. Okay?
Thank you.
Is it warm in here?
Just relax, Dad. Breathe. Everything's gonna be fine.
You know, Jim, I know what you're going through, but once you have faced your fears, you will feel tremendously vital. Mm. You know, my late husband, Bucky, was afraid of flying his entire life. But when he turned 50, Bucky decided to take the bull by the horns and go skydiving.
And after that, he loved flying.
I'll never know. Bucky's parachute didn't open.
Oh. Mrs. Blake, I'd love to get a couple of minutes alone with my dad, Mrs. Blake. Thank you.
They'll move him back to his own room in a couple of hours. He a friend of yours?
Yeah.
Your boyfriend?
Uh-huh.
Seems like a nice guy.
I think so.
They cut off his arm.
Yeah, I know.
My friend Josh from chemo, they cut off his leg a year ago, and he's going skiing in Stratton this Christmas.
Hmm. Well, that's good to know. So what about you? When are they gonna let you out of this place?
Tomorrow. I don't come back till March. Only 4 more operations to go.
That's great.
It's not so bad here, really. The worst part is you always want to go home. My mom and I live in an apartment. It's kind of small, and I can't make any noise after 8:30. Because Miss Beck bangs on the wall if I do. But I just miss being there, you know?
Yeah, I think I do.
Well, I'll see ya.
Bye.
You can do this.
I don't think so.
Dad, you're tough, okay? You live with Mom. Come on, you could face these people.
One-on-one, yes, but there's a big group out there. They're all gonna be staring at
me. Okay, that's fine, so stare right back at them. And when you do, picture them in their underwear.
I can't do that.
Sure you can. Nobody's intimidating in their underwear, right? So just picture them in their boxers covered with ducks and bunnies.
These are my patients' families. I can't think of them like that. It's embarrassing.
Okay, fine. Forget the people. They're just go-betweens anyway. Focus on the dogs. That's where the real audience is, right?
Right.
Okay, so go out there and reach those dogs.
Can we?
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Jim Hansen, DVM.
Thank you all for being here. I'm sorry about earlier in the week when I was indisposed and unable to properly face the faces.
What are we gonna do? Quick, think of something, Rob.
Give Dad a chance. He'll come through this time.
Ask me whether it's more humane to bring a house sitter in for the dog for the holidays or to put the pet in the kennel.
I always like to say, ask your dog.
All right, you ready?
For what?
You need some exercise. No more feeling sorry for yourself. Put him in the chair, Oscar.
Now, wait a minute, Ben. You can't just come in here.
You obviously haven't had occupational therapy. Can't is not in our vocabulary.
All right, now will you tell me what's going on?
In case I don't see you before I leave tomorrow, have a nice life. Aren't you gonna shake my hand?
I won't stay long.
I know it's not your fault about my arm. That's what this is all about.
No. I just wanted to bring you something to remind you of home.
Sid, please.
Tonight's episode of Providence featured the music of Bruce Springsteen from the box set tracks.